Myself Pushpa. Today I would like to present a lecture on feedback amplifiers. Before going to feedback amplifiers, first we know about the amplifier. So what is an amplifier? So generally amplifiers. So amplifier means in the name itself we have which amplifies the signal. Otherwise we can say generally if we will take any of the amplifier, so this amplifier which strengthens the weak signal. So if we will give any of the signal here, so that signal like suppose if we will give some 3 millivolt signal here as our input here. So this amplifier which strengthens this voltage. So whatever the signal we applied for that signal which gives that like more voltage which gives compared to input. So that here your voltage it may be more than 3 millivolts. So we may consider either 4 millivolts or 5 millivolts. Or in simple way we can also mention that generally amplifier which amplifies the signal. So that here like basically based on this amplifier we have many types of amplifiers. Because here when we said that we are applying the input signal. So which type of input signal we are applying? So whatever the signal, like whatever the analog signal we are applying, that analog signal we may apply like in terms of voltage or in terms of current. That is why when you are applying that signal here, we can consider that your input voltage will be either current input or voltage input. So basically we can say that like when we are classifying these amplifiers, we have many types. So we can consider it as either voltage amplifiers we have, current amplifiers we have, or transconductance amplifiers we have, or transresistance amplifiers we have. So all these amplifiers we are dividing based on the input and output impedances. Based on those only we are saying that whether it is voltage amplifier or current amplifier or transresistance or transconductance. So that here now depends on the amplifier only. From this amplifier only now we are we can discuss our feedback amplifier. Now we know what is an amplifier. Then now we'll see that what is feedback amplifier. So here, see basically now if you take one amplifier here. So we have an amplifier. Now what we assume that here, suppose if we are applying our input is voltage input signal if we are applying. So that here we'll assume that our input signal is voltage. So that here we'll say we'll take that our input is VI. So that here what is our output signal here we will get? V naught will get. Simply if you will observe this signal here, it is open loop signal. We are applying input and we are taking output. But here suppose in the input signal if any noise is present. So here when we are taking that amplified version of the output, in the amplified version of the output your noise is also amplified. Because what we are saying that this amplifier which strengthens the weak signal now. So in the weak signal if noise is there, that noise is also amplified here. So in your output noise is also increased. So it will be considered as one of the disadvantage only. We should get amplified version of the output, but that must be like noise must be removed in that. So if you see this circuit, simply we can call this circuit as the open loop circuit. So from the open loop circuit we cannot reduce the noise here. So that here what we are doing, here we are applying a sampler here. So that here by applying the sampler here, so that output signal whatever we got from the open loop amplifier here, that output signal we are giving to a sampler network. So that here we have this sampling network here. So that here when we are taking your output, so that fraction of the signal will be taken from the sampler here. And before that here we need to remember one thing. Whenever we are saying that amplifier, when a transistor works as an amplifier, whenever we give that source voltage or source signal and the load is given. So that here what we are doing, here we need to apply a load here. So that load is denoted with RL. And here at the input we need to give source signal VS here. So that here when we have given the source signal and load, now you can say this is your amplifier. Now as we said initially what we have said, whenever we have applied that input signal here, we got output, in the output noise is not removed. So that to remove the noise here, through the sampling network, fraction of the output signal will be taken as input here. So that this fraction of the signal, where we need to apply here, we need to apply to a feedback. feedback network here. So that feedback network is denoted with beta. So that here when we are applying that output as an input to your feedback network. Now what is the input to your feedback network? V naught is input to your feedback network. Then from the feedback network, here we are taking our output. Now here, why we are applying feedback here? Because to reduce the noise in the output signal here. So when we are applying feedback network here, basically in the feedback network we have two types. So we have positive feedback and negative feedback. So depends on our requirement, you can apply either positive or negative feedback. But most of the times we will use negative feedback only. And here, depends on the feedback network output, we got output is VF here, right? Now here, see, now how to take again, how to apply this feedback output as input to your amplifier again, that we need to see here. So that in the input circuit, we have one more network, that network is called as the mixer, okay? So that network we can call it as mixer, or we can also call this network as the comparator. Or in simple way, we can also say this as the error signal. So that error signal we can also represent in terms of E of t if we will denote all these equations in terms of time domain. Okay. Now, sorry. Here, see, now when we have taken that feedback signal here. Now initially when we have applied that source signal which is applied to your mixer network here. Now, from the feedback network, whatever the output you got here, that output and your source signal, both signals which are compared at the comparator or mixer. So initially we assume that here, suppose we have applied that input signal, some 3 millivolt signal as we applied earlier here. So we will assume that this we have applied our signal in the positive, in in-phase signal. So now here when we have taken our amplified version of the signal, you got your output amplified version, but in the signal noise is present. Now here when we have applied this output signal as input to your feedback network here, see now what is our input, which is in phase only now. Now here when you are taking your feedback signal here, suppose if we will assume that here we have taken positive feedback here. So when you have taken here positive feedback here, so in your in the output signal, noise will be removed by the feedback network. But here, as it is in phase signal and due to positive signal here, you got positive peak voltage only we got here. Now what we are doing here, see now from the source signal, as default always we will apply your input voltage in terms of positive. Suppose if you are applying here some 1 millivolt of signal if you have applied here. So here you have positive signal and here you have positive signal. Both signals are same only now with same sign. So that here both signals are combined here. Both signals are added. So that here by addition of these two signals we can write it as Vs plus Vf. So these two signals are combined at the mixer. Now these two signals together we are applying as input to your amplifier. So that which will become your Vi. So let's see here in the earlier case Vi is only 3 millivolts we have applied. Now like when you have taken your feedback signal voltage and source voltage signal both are combined so that your input is increased now. So your input it will become now almost 4 millivolts like that. Now when you will take your output voltage, it will become in the amplified version more than 4 millivolts you will get. Again if you will apply to your feedback network, this cycle which rotates continuously, which repeats, and every time your output voltage will be increases only. So this happens here due to positive feedback, because here we mentioned the condition that is positive feedback. So what happens in the positive feedback, your gain which is increases, your gain of the amplifier, feedback amplifier is increases, and gain with feedback is also increases. Suppose if you will see negative feedback amplifier, okay, so if we will consider the negative feedback amplifier, due to negative feedback, see here we considered initially positive feedback, now we are considering the negative feedback. So due to negative feedback here, what happens here, your output voltage value will be decreases and noise is also removed. And here if you will compare this signal with your input signal here, so both signals, like in these signals if you will consider the difference, because one, your source signal will be in the in-phase form and your feedback signal will be in the out-of-phase form. So that here you will get difference for these two signals. So that here when you will consider difference, their output also will be reduces. So that here in the negative feedback amplifier, your gain value with feedback, your amplifier value, gain value is also decreases. So from this we can we will understand that like by applying which type of feedback we can reduce the noise in the amplifiers. So we'll continue in the next class. Thank you.